take out the other two pegs and insert them on the top. And then once you're done with that, you take the cap and insert it on the Velcro on the peg. And now your little lounge is complete. Hi, I'm Anthony Belso. I'm one of the founders of the Little Lounge. The Little Lounge brings an iconic new simple way for public seating. If you're ever stuck at a bus stop, a line, or even at the beach, take a Little Lounge with you. You can sit down.
Now, just to prove to you how strong the Little Lounge is, I'm a pretty big guy and I'm sitting on it, it's just fine. And now we came across this problem as in Ocean City. There's a lot of bus stops that have dirty bus seats, or there's no bus seats at all. At the boardwalk, you might be there, and there's no places to sit. Now, this solves the problem that there's a lack of public seating.
So, for justification, we sent out a survey on different social media sites, and we got some pretty good results, I'd say. Our first question asked, would you want to sit down in public if there's no seating available? And about 96, I believe, percent of the people said yes, they would. Our next question was, would you care to have a large folding chair? Because ours is obviously smaller than a folding chair. So after that, a lot of people once again said no, they would not want to care about a large folding chair. It's kind of self-explanatory. And about 94% of people said yes to that. Then we said, would you buy a smaller version of a chair and carry it around with you? And a lot of people once again said yes. As you can see, we only got about 75 votes for that one. But after our results were pretty good, and we got a lot of good feedback.
All right, so in researching existing patents, we found these four problems. We found two camping chairs, pocket chair, and a sit bed. But they all like attempted to solve the same problem that we were solving, but they all have a slight convenience issue. The two camping chairs are very bulky and they're kind of hard to carry around. The pocket chair, the design was too frail, and it cannot like support overweight people. And the pocket chair is kind of like awkward to sit on because you have to like lean on it. But our chair, we wanted to make it so that it was, it could hold overweight people, it was easy to carry around, and it wasn't obvious.
Now for materials, originally we considered new materials like metals, woods, plastics, and then PVC. However, we ruled out metals and some other material because they were too expensive. They weigh too much, and we could use other materials that were just as strong and were lighter.
So for our planning, each one of us made eight different sketches, and we all combined our best features that we believed that our sketches had, and in result we got a sketch similar to this. We then turned around and went on Autodesk Inventor, which is a 3D modeling system that we use, and we made an example of what we were thinking would look like. We did make some refinements to it, however, like at first, this part of the chair right here was on this side, and it was smaller. So then we turned around and made it a little bit larger. Instead of pocket size, we made it backpack size, and we moved this to the back right here. We also showed how the inside would work. We colored all the pegs inside different colors to show where each peg would be, and then we once again refined that and got our top picture.
Now here's some of the math we used. We had to make sure that PVC could actually support her. So we used a mathematical equation that determines stress, force, and area. So first we need to find the stress. And using an online tool, we found a stress versus strain curve, which shows where a material breaks. And we found the maximum yield strength. And then using that, we found stress because we had the area already. Plugging the two we have into the equation, we found that each PVC pipe could hold 500 equivalent pounds.
All right, so here's some pictures of us completing the build process. First, we had to measure the materials, which was the wood and the plastic. Then we had to actually cut out the materials of wood and PVC pipe. And then we had to assemble the frame and then attach our floor hips at the bottom of each of the pegs.
So for our testing, one day we went to the boardwalk to test out some different things. First, we tested out how much weight the body can support with the pegs. We also tested how well it does with different surfaces. So first, for our weight, we took a bunch of different weights, ranging from 50 pounds to 150 pounds, and we each applied each weight to the chair. We were seeing if like any parts of the body came shift, so it's not really much of a